a very foggy night, though the gas lamps were alight, you couldn't see the end of your nose. We had just gone off to bed when my wife sat up and said, "You're going to take the dog out, I suppose." I said, "It's very foggy, but I'll take him. Perhaps he ought to go have a breath of air." But my heart went in my feet when he scampered up the street, and I simply couldn't find the little doggy anywhere. I lost my way in a thick, thick fog, in a thick, thick fog in London. It was 9:30. I was taking out the dog in a thick, thick fog in London. I wandered round and round and round the houses. I couldn't find a policeman anywhere. And at 2:30, when the moon broke through, I was all alone with Nelson in Trafalgar Square. I wandered on and on and on and round and round about. If I went home without the dog, my wife would turn me out. She thinks a lot about it. Alas, it's very true. To her, the dog is number one, and I come number two. I wandered by the tower, and I fell into the moat. A policeman dragged me out of there and dragged me by the coat. He said, "My lad, I think you've had a drop too much to drink." I said, "Well, you're a blooming fool, if that is what you think." I found my way back home and found a sight to make me weep. But there beside the bed I saw the little dog asleep. My wife was all standoffish, got right up on the shelf. I said, "When next it's foggy, you can hear the dog yourself."